So fine, today's topic for data compression is the uniform quantization. As we are working on the fourth unit, we are done with the quantization problem, and we have understood the concept, what actually the quantization is, right? Now, in this particular, we are going to learn about the uniform quantization. So first of all, let me tell you that when I say what are the different types of quantizations, then the answer goes that there are two types of quantization, and they are termed to be as the uniform quantization and second one to be as non-uniform quantization. What actually the uniform quantization is, first we will understand what is uniform quantization, and then we will switch over to the next one. So the uniform quantization is what? In this particular quantization, the levels, the quantization levels are equally spaced, or I can say uniformly spaced. That is why they are termed to be as uniform quantization. See, what is the meaning of the uniform? Uniform meaning is the uniformity or the consistency. That means the intervals in the quantization is uniform or are equal or are of constant value. So that is why those are called as uniform quantization, right? We will see non-uniform quantization, in which we say just the opposite, that whenever we have the quantization levels which are non-uniformly spaced or unequally spaced, which are not constant, which does not have the same value, that particular is called as the non-uniform quantization. So they are simply relating to their names. So firstly, let's see what are uniform quantizers, right? Quantization is a process, and quantizer is the one with the help of which we are working on with the process of quantization, right? So now, when I say, or when I talk about this quantization, uniform quantization is the simplest type of quantizer when I talk about uniform quantizer. Now what happens? As you all remember, in our earlier lecture, we have seen how the quantization take place, right? How the quantization is done. So if we have a continuous sequence of signal, then what we are doing, this is an analog signal, what we are doing, we are digitizing it, right? We are digitizing it. So somewhere when we are digitizing it to a specific point, then this particular information is being lost, right? This particular information is being lost due to the digitization, and this particular part is the quantization. So some distortion, some noise, or some error is defined here, and that is why this particular quantization is for the lossy compression, because here we are losing some information. That is why it is for the lossy compression. Now, here in the uniform quantizer, all the intervals in the uniform quantizer are of same size. When I say same size, that means the spacing between the two intervals will be equal. Let's see here. If I say 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and 3 to 4. Now, here you can say that the difference between the interval is 1 in every point, in every interval at the input point. You can take from this side also. This is again 1. This is again minus 1 to minus 2, 1. This is again minus 2 to minus 3, 1 and 1. So this is the uniformity, or we can say the size of the interval is same or equal or constant in the uniform quantizer. Second thing, the decision boundaries are equally spaced. So at the output level also, what you have, you can see the equal, intervals. Now, same, the reconstruction values are also spaced evenly with the same spacing as the decision boundaries. So So here also you can see the same equally spaced intervals. Now the constant spacing is usually referred to as the step size and is denoted by delta. Now what is this delta? You can see here the step which is created here. This is called as stepwise. As in the graph also you can say this particular steps are created due to the equal intervals of the uniform quantizer, and this equal spacing or the constant spacing is referred to as step size, and also we denote it in the mathematical equations by delta, where delta is every time equal to 1 in a uniform quantizer, or we can say that it will be every time even in the that means every delta will have the same value for this particular uniform quantizer, right? Now there are two important features about this particular uniform quantizer. What is that? The two important features of uniform quantizer are, first, except possibly the rightmost and the leftmost intervals along x-axis are uniformly spaced, right? So here you can see that except the rightmost and the leftmost, all the intervals are equally spaced at the input point. So this is the input point. This is the input point. That means the x-axis. And here you talk about 4, that is leftmost and minus 4, leftmost and rightmost. Apart from these two, all the intervals are equally spaced, you can see here, right? Now, second thing, except possibly the outer interval, the reconstruction level of the quantizer are uniformly spaced. So similarly, when we talk about the, output interval, output point, then also you can see that the, apart from the outer intervals, all intervals are equally spaced, right? So this is what I am telling you through the graph or through the uniform quantizer graph, which will help you to understand what actually the uniform quantizer is. Now, when we talk about different types of uniform quantizer, there are two types of uniform quantizers. They are termed to be as the first one as mid-rise type, and the second one is called as the mid-tread type. So these are the two types of uniform quantizer. What are those? First, we talk about the mid-rise quantizer. So in mid-rise quantizer, what we will see in this particular type, this is called so because the origin lies in the middle of a raising part of a staircase-like graph. That means this is this graph. You can see here in this particular graph, this is the x-axis, that is the input. This is the y-axis, that is the output, that is the reconstruction values. And here you can see the graph which is being created. So it is rising from here, from 0.5, not from 0. Here also it is rising from minus 0.5, not from 0. So the origin lies in the middle rising part, in the middle, right? Not at the 0 point. So that is why it is called as mid-rise. The rise is starting from the midpoint. That is why it is called as the mid-rise type of quantizer. Now in this particular, the quantization levels in this type are even numbers. Now this is again an important feature, and you have to remember this always, that this type of quantizer will have the levels which are of even numbers. Now you can see here that at the input level, you can see 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 2, minus 3, sorry, 4. All these are what? These are the even numbers. The quantization level are even numbers. Second thing, the zero representation is never included in the mid-rise quantizer. So in the mid-rise quantizer, we do not represent the zero. Why we are calling it so? We are calling it so because here you can see, as I have told you earlier also, the origin is not lying at zero. This particular is left. Zero is not represented in this quantizer. It is starting from the 0.5. So that is why we are saying that no representation of zero is included in the mid-rise, and that is the main feature, and this is how you can differentiate between the mid-rise and the mid-red quantizer. Second thing, this particular mid-rise quantizers are mainly applied or used wherever there are even number of intervals needed. Wherever there is odd number of intervals need, we do not use the mid-rise quantizer. We always use the mid-rise quantizers are used for the even numbers. So in every application, wherever we are using the even numbers. One more thing, in example, whenever we do not have any representation of zero, example for audio, we can never use this mid-rise quantization. Why we cannot use? Because in an audio, whenever there is silence, the zero is there in the graph. So that particular zero cannot be represented in this. So mid-rise quantizer cannot be used for this particular audio or speech compression, right? So that is the main application. Again, now we switch over to the second type of quantizer, which is called as the mid-red quantizer. Now, what is this mid-red quantizer? This is just the difference from the mid-rise is, it is starting from the origin level, that is from the zero. So what we say, the main and the first line you can include is representation of zero is always included in the mid-red quantizer. So how you can say that? This particular, just look at this particular point. This is input as x-axis. This is y as output. And here you can see this is the origin, that is the zero. And this particular zero is represented here. Right. So the graph, that is the staircase, is starting from zero, right, and then rising. So that is why it is called as mid-red quantizer. Now, in this second point is, this quantization have the quantization levels which are odd in numbers. Now you can see the odd numbers 0.5, 1.5, 2.5, 3.5, and so on and so forth. So here, all these are what? These are the odd numbers. So whenever we have the odd numbers representation or quantization levels, then we are going to work on with the mid-red quantizer. Now, this is again a staircase-like graph, but the difference from the mid-rise is it is starting from the origin, that is from zero. In the earlier, the mid-rise was not including the zero, while this is including the zero, right? So this is a staircase graph. Now, if you can just focus on this particular part, this part, and you just focus here, then you can easily make out the difference between the mid-rise and mid-red quantizer, right? So that is here. When I say in the mid-rise, I told you about audio. So for audio compression or speech compression, what we can use? We can use mid-red, because whenever there is a silence in the speech or in the audio, you have to represent it with zero. So here you can represent it with the help of zero. So that is what we define it as with the mid-red quantizer. Again, in control systems also, you can work on with this mid-red quantizer. So these are certain applications where you can work on with the mid-red quantizers. So I hope you have understood what is uniform quantization and what are the two different types of uniform quantizers, that is mid-rise and mid-red.